decision I'm willy nilly. These six women worked hard. They deliberated yesterday, more than 12 hours today. They wanted a list of all the evidence. They had all the evidence in that jury room. So the one thing that is obvious that these six women have thought long and hard about their decision. But yes, they have come to consensus. It's a unanimous verdict one way or the other. And again, there is George Zimmerman. And I can't imagine what that moment is like. Because he has no idea and he has no control over what is about to happen. Now the reaction. Now, what will George Zimmerman's reaction be if it's guilty? But on the other hand, what will be the reaction on the other side of the courtroom? For Tracy Martin, for Sabrina Fulton, who just over a year ago lost their son, who they'll never get back, who are looking for justice. And justice for them means that this man gets convicted. For George Zimmerman and his family, he's been saying this is a wrongful prosecution that's been motivated by things outside of law enforcement, outside of the system of justice, that it was politics, that it was some sort of pressure placed on Angela Corby, some sort of pressure placed on our system that put him in that chair to face these charges to begin with.
The system?
Jury.
They anonymous until after.
You know, for George Zimmerman, he walks out, he's free. For Tracy Martin and Sabrina Fulton, if George Zimmerman is found guilty, yes, there's a sense, some sense of justice. But Trayvon's not coming back. My colleague Nancy Grace is with us now. Nancy, a verdict has been reached. Nancy. Your thoughts right here, right now.
Nancy Grace.
Nancy?
Also, can I hear
you? Okay, we're still waiting to get hooked up with Nancy Grace. As soon as she can hear me, Nancy, just jump in as soon as you can. This is the courtroom. And again, I don't know if everyone is in there yet. Obviously, the judge is not there yet. But what will happen is the judge will take the bench, and then they'll have to bring in the six women of Seminole County who will deliver this verdict. But I have not seen Sabrina Fulton, Tracy Martin yet. I have not seen Mark O'Mara. There's Mark O'Mara. Mark O'Mara, Don West, and the defense team is there, so they are ready to hear. But as I watch George Zimmerman, the one thing that strikes me, that he's not moving.
Scared.
Seeming almost paralyzed there. There's his father, his mother, his
wife.
He
should have been paralyzed at night.
In the front row. George Zimmerman does not have children. But he is married. The tension inside that courtroom, I can't imagine. I can't imagine. And it's for everyone involved.
Uh-oh, here
everyone's
you go.
Rising. The judge is taking the bench. Let's listen in, ladies and gentlemen.
I understand that we have a verdict. Are we ready for the jury to come in?
We are, Your
Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, let's go ahead and bring him in. To be no outburst upon the reading of the verdict or afterwards.
Really? That must be the jury coming in right now.
Sarah.
Oh my God. She ready.
She happy. Is she ready yet?
She ready.
To herself.
Please be seated.
She smiled.
Members of the jury, have you reached a verdict? If you'll please fold the verdict form and hand it to Deputy Jarvis.
She's She eating it.
Okay, if you'll please pause.
Damn.
In the Circuit Court of the 18th Judicial Circuit in and for Seminole County, Florida, State of Florida versus George Zimmerman. Verdict, we the jury find George Zimmerman not guilty. So say we all, four person.
Is either side 1-2?
She's free.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as your juror number is being called, please answer whether this is your verdict.
Juror B, 21, is this your verdict?
Yes.
Juror B, 76, is this your verdict?
Yes.
Juror B, 37, is this your verdict?
Yes.
Juror B, 51, is this your verdict?
Yes.
Juror E, 6, is this your verdict?
Yes.
Juror E, 40, is this your verdict?
Yes.
Thank you.
Ladies, I wish to thank you for your time and consideration of this case. I also wish to advise you of some very special privileges enjoyed by jurors. No juror could ever be required to talk about the discussions that occurred in the jury room, except by court order. For many centuries, our society has relied upon juries for consideration of difficult cases. We have recognized for hundreds of years that a jury's deliberations, discussions, and votes should remain their private affair as long as they wish it. Therefore, the law gives you a unique privilege not to speak about the jury's work. Although you are at liberty to speak with anyone about your deliberations, you are also at liberty to refuse to speak to anyone. A request to discuss either your verdict or your deliberations may come from those who are simply curious, from those who might seek to find fault with you, from the media, from the attorneys, or elsewhere. It will be up to you to decide whether to preserve your privacy as a juror. Is there anything we need to take up before the jury, before they're sent back to the jury room to be discharged?
No, thank you.
Ladies, thank you very much. You will be taken back to the jury room to be discharged.
This don't even seem real. This is fucked up.
Seated. Mr. Zimmerman, I've signed the judgment that confirms the jury's verdict. Your bond will be released. Your GPS monitor will be cut off when you exit the courtroom over here. And you have no further business with the court. Okay, thank you. Is there anything else this court needs to pick up before we recess for this case? Thank you all very much. Court is, the evidence will be released. The evidence will be released.
Can't believe this. It's over.